My wife and I moved to the lake about 30 years ago and built our home there. I would be sitting on the shoreline and these interesting sticks would wash ashore with all these teeth marks in them all over the place. And I would sort of gather individual pieces of driftwood and I would bring them up to the studio and just lean them up against the wall because they were interesting in their own right. And essentially, a big pile of sticks in the studio became my art practice. We go out into the woods and we look for ironwood. Ironwood is a material that has an undulating quality to it. It grows not very uniform, and that for me is very interesting. So when bringing it to the studio, we would actually harvest the wood, bring it in, strip the bark off. We ended up sanding it all back. And some of these limbs that you're seeing are 13 feet high. Wood has an ephemeral quality to it. It looks like, depending on the situation, it has checks, cracks, splits, knots. I remove all those. I want this one particular piece of wood to be in its perfect form without showing the blemishes that acquire over time. Well, one of the things that I love about doing this type of installation is that there's no front or back, or there's no up or down to it, just gravity. And we're suspending gravity for a moment. It's a frozen moment in time. And I think that doesn't matter which way you approach the piece, it'll always be interesting and different. The successful part of it for me is to actually have the viewer enjoy it for a minute or 5 seconds, just a break in their everyday life, just to be able to stop for a moment and see art is, I think, a special thing. I feel very fortunate that Simons gave me the opportunity to be able to create this monumental piece of artwork within their premises. And to bring in something, a natural quality, into an urban environment, it's a little bit of artifice. It allows the person to say, hey, why is this here? How come this is here? And what's it all about?